Well, the origins of the Academy Museum are extremely interesting. 1929, Douglas Fairbanks and Mary Pickford, who were the founders of the Academy, said that Los Angeles needed a library about film and also a film museum. The most recent version of the museum, the May Company building, which is this wonderful department store here in Los Angeles that has a gold facade on it. It looks like a stack of gold film canisters. It's right next to the Los Angeles County Museum of Art. And what Renzo Piano is doing, who's the architect that we brought on board to create this museum, what he's doing is creating a 1,000-seat theater, spherical in shape, that will give us an amazing theater. And on the top of that building, above the theater, is a terrace in which you can look out over the Hollywood Hills, even with the Hollywood sign in view. We've got the older building, and you have it meeting with glass bridges. This new spherical building, which is a state-of-the-art factory-looking, let's call it a kind of dream factory, of a theater that sits across the way, the two joining, and as Renzo likes to say, flirting with one another through these glass bridges. Well, of course, to build such a complex project as a proper film museum, first of all, you have to have a major collection. The library had already acquired over the years a wonderful, wonderful collection of works on paper, posters, annotated screenplays, 12 million photographs, a lot of storyboards, and works on paper, the archives of Alfred Hitchcock, for example. So you have to have a collection as a base. And then the film archive has acquired 100,000 different elements of film, which gives us a great collection to draw from for film as well. We're gonna have major projections all through the building. It won't be just objects, it'll also be the moving image, which will be incorporated into the exhibitions so that these objects come back to life when you're actually seeing the films. We're gonna show in the museum the power of film, how it was the greatest art form of the 20th century, how it's changing now in the 21st century to become many different art forms. And we're going to be able to put you in a kind of immersive environment to take you back to the 19th century to begin with, and then bring you all the way up to the present so that you actually feel like you're back in time, back when film was first invented, and then going through numerous stages to get to the present. One of the great things that this museum has that most other film museums don't is access to the great filmmakers and the great stars. And we have access to those people who will show up at the openings, of course, but also we have access to them to do public programs and for educational purposes, so that we can invite people to come to educational programs and meet some of the greatest people who do work in the moving image in the world.
The Academy Museum will also have the perspective and the story of filmmaking through the eyes of filmmakers. And I think what people will experience when they go to the museum is they will get a sense of the actual human beings that struggle and make these movies, and not some sort of monolithic studio complex that has created them. And that is going to be, I think, revelatory.